Everyone to Advantage Ventures. We are an advisory supporting the social entrepreneurship and social investments in Asia. So we are very honored to be with ordinary people. 他们是非常有创投、有创意，还有很多丰富的经验，可以跟我们分享这个题目，就是那个社会企业创投，还有公益创投。所以我先邀请那个是David Green， 他是 Ashoka 的 Vice President。 还有下一个就是 Tom Wang， 他是 co-founder of Flow Fund from Taiwan。 下一个就是 Marie So， co-founder of Sherpin Ventures in Development。
这白的一条多难看。下一个就是
Hideyuki Inoue， founder and president of Social Ventures Tokyo Partners Tokyo。 还有那个 Kelvin Chen。 Founder and CEO of Qi Fong. 还有最后一个嘉宾是 Patrick Jern, China President of Ashoka.
China. Hello, hi, morning, everybody. My name is Tom. I'm here to represent Flow. We are based in Taiwan. We are an investment company. We are focused on social enterprise startups. So in other words, we help entrepreneurs to start up new companies. Right now, we are helping an NGO in Taiwan to become a social enterprise. By social enterprise, I mean an organization that can make money like any other enterprises, but at the same time can create social values. The organization I'm helping with in Taiwan is a human resources company. Basically, it employs the disabled people and give them training and help them to get work skills so they can work for a living. I'll share more of the stories from Taiwan later. Thank you so much.
Good morning. My name is Hideyuki Inoue from Tokyo. This is my first visit to Beijing. Actually, all I know about Beijing is the airport and this hotel so far. please let me know how wonderful this city is there. Anyway, I'm the founder of the Social Venture Partners in Tokyo. This is Japan's first venture philanthropy association. Venture philanthropy is we try to apply the business skills and venture capital models to a non-profit organization which, or social businesses which has a strong problem-solving models. And we try to collect business people's time and money to invest in social ventures. So we call our members a partner. And every partner contribute $1,000 US dollars to our fund, and then we invest in innovative social ventures in terms of money and also their own time, using their skills such as accounting skills, strategy skills, PL, media skills, and then find out, try to reach social innovation through our development, our investments. And also, which is very important for us, is try to change our partner's career, well, in a way of life, way of thinking. You know, our partner learns so much from our investees, how about social issues, what's going on in our society. So our goal, we have a dual mission. One is, you know, change through our investees. And second one is change through our partners. So some of our partners try to change their own company, or some of our partners change their own career and then join nonprofit or social ventures and so on. Okay, thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Colin.
Chen, and my Chinese name is Chen Guoquan. I represent Qifang, which is a for-profit Chinese company in Shanghai, which has a simple mission, which is to give everyone a way to pay for their education. We believe that you shouldn't have to be rich in order to realize your full potential. And so what Qifang is a website where Chinese students can register and find people, individuals, companies, foundations who will help sponsor their education. We also believe, like one foundation, that all of us can make, with a little bit of effort, make a big difference. So each home can actually have people helping with as little as 50 RMB. So very small bits can all come together and help people realize their dreams and change their whole families and their communities. Qifang is a social venture, so we are based on a for-profit model. And we'd love to share some of those ideas with all of you today.
Good morning, dear friends. My name is Patrick Chang. 中文名字张瑞林，我是 I'm representing Asoka. I'm the chief representative for Asoka in China, responsible for setting up the operation here. So for the sake of better communication, I will shift to Mandarin if you allow me. 大家好，我是 阿育皇中国的首席代表张瑞林。 谁是阿育皇？这里很多人有可能都听过了。Bill Drayton， 我们那个创办人1981年的时候创办阿育皇，他的目的就是在全世界的范畴里面选举一批很优秀的社会企业家，这些人能改变，能提出新型的模式去改变这社会的问题。 到目前为止，我们已经选举了2300个社会企业家，在不同的那个社会议题上的层面在工作。那我们的信念是什么呢？我们觉得我们人类现在正在面临一个很关键的历史时刻，很多的公民开始。 参与到这个解决社会问题，而不光是等待政府的引导，不是等待商业社会的那个决定，而是说很创新的举办很多社会企业，能找到一些解决我们基础变化社会所需要出现的更多解决新的问题。 那阿苏克在中国希望做什么呢？我们觉得中国政府非常成功的引导了我们经济方面的改革，让我们上亿的人口就是能脱贫。下一步这个中国的改革关键的地方就是体制的改革，怎么样每一个人好像。 我们 Jack Lee 所提倡的，一点一小点一小点，看到不好的地方就不要说骂骂政府就算了，而是说卷起袖子，大家一块来工作。阿苏克在全球2300个阿育皇的伙伴，他们都有非常多的创新理念，我们希望能把这些他们。 过去的成功的经验以及失败的经验能引到中国，可以能让大家站在这个肩上，这总结能更高的发挥中国的创新力。我相信中国这个创新力同样好像经济方面的创新力这么成功，然后回报那个世界那个群体，让我们成为世界公民的一个部分。谢谢。
大家好，我叫舒芷君，我是香港来的。2006年的时候，我在哈佛大学毕业，就跟我一个同学曹宇三女士，她是台湾来的，因此创办了我们这个社会企业的组织叫 Ventures and Development。 我们的宗旨是希望在大中华地区推广社会企业这个概念。这个概念这个地区是比较挺新的。我们是希望通过这个社会企业业务模式，去解决一些贫穷还有经济发展的问题。2006年开始到现在是3年的时间，我们。 因为经验不多，所以就是说我们要通过自己去学习什么是一个社会企业，这是怎么一回事，去来那个 是这个模式，所以我们在四部青海跟云南有两个商务，两个社会企业。第一个是两个都是针对这个贫穷的问题，针对提高收入的问题。所以我们在云南有一个毛粮奶酪的商务，在当地的牧民通过做奶酪，然后卖到国内的六星级酒店、五星级酒店，开发一个市场过来。然后第二个商务在青海的，就是通过那个发展那个牦牛的那个毛，它本身跟羊绒的质量很相近，不过一直没有人去发展，所以我们希望通过用这个牦牛这个绒去开发一个时装，就大众时装这个市场。我们现在开始了三年，在全世界有200多个店去放我们的产品，我们这个品牌。我们在青海有15000个部门跟我们合作，所以希望通过我们这个社会企业这个模式，可以帮当地的人破贫啊，通过我们这个商业的方式可以解决那个贫穷的问题。所以今天希望跟大家可以分享我们三年内的一些做社会企业的一些经验，谢谢。
Ni hao ma. I'm David Green. I'm an Ashoka Fellow. And I do work under the heading of compassionate capitalism. I set up social enterprises that are market driving, that work on the principles of capitalism, but where revenues and production capacity are used to serve people, where profit is a means to an end rather than the end itself. And so what we do is we try to maximize distribution while being profitable. And so some of the examples of enterprises that I've helped develop are mainly in eye care for treating cataract blindness and restoring vision. Cataract is the main cause of blindness in the world. And so, for instance, I workin helping to develop Aravind Eye Hospital in South India. And they do that. They're the largest eye care group in the world. They do over 300,000 surgeries a year. One third pay nothing, one third pay two thirds cost, and another third pay well above cost. And with that model, they're able to be highly profitable. They made $20 million last year, and they spent $11 million. And so we're spreading that model all over the world to many different countries. In fact, we're working with Professor Yunus with Grameen Health, setting up Grameen Eye Hospitals. And the other work that I do is setting up manufacturing to make medical products affordable. And the best example is Auralab in South India. It's next to Aravind Eye Hospital. And we make the artificial lenses that are surgically implanted in the eye when you do cataract surgery. And when we started manufacturing, those lenses cost $300 a piece, and we brought the price down to $2 a piece, and now we have 8% of the global market share, and we sell 1.5 million lenses a year now. The other work that I do is in hearing care, making hearing devices affordable, again, under the same framework of how do you reduce cost and price to bring it within the reach of low-income people. And the other thing that I work on, mainly through Ashoka, is social investing, creating social investing funds. So one of the funds we created is an eye fund to help eye care programs that are already self-financing but need money for scaling. And so one of those investments is here in China, the Her Eye System in Liaoning Province. And then we're also working on a solar fund to look at how the criteria by which investment is made from our solar fund can tilt the whole field towards affordable solar energy for low-income people. Thank you very much.
谢谢大家的介绍。那么其实我们这个题目是蛮大的，两个那个有盈利的社会企业，还有那个公益创投。其实我们本来是有一个小时，目前我就有人告诉我要半个小时来把这两个题目来讲，所以我们就尽快一点。Actually, our session has been shortened a little, so we're going to really focus on just talking about from your perspective of starting a what is a successful social enterprise with a social business model, and then from the investment point of view, the venture philanthropy. So perhaps if we could start with you know, the sustainable social enterprises from Marie and Shoke.
开始一个社会企业很重要的就是要知道自己的宗旨是什么，所以我们开始时候我们的宗旨就是说要解决社会上的一个问题，无论问题是什么，是教育方面，是收入方面的问题，是不是找工作的问题，我们要很清楚知道我们开始这个企业的目的，一定要解决到社会上的一个问题。然后第二部分就是说，我们怎么可以营运？我们怎么可以有基金去长期发展起来？因为开启一个企业就是不是说三年立业项目点，两年立业项目，然后解决了就完了，对吧？因为是一定要持续性的发展。我们也是希望我们帮地区那些人，我们可以把他的本身的质量提高，他们可以自己帮助自己去生活下去。所以开启一个社会企业宗旨是非常非常重要。我们开始三年其实经历很多很困难的事情，很容易的有成功的例子，也有很困难的事情。第一个比较困难的就是开始一个企业，当然也杂志对吧，其实机制上的问题，我们在哪里找到第一桶金，这样说对吧，去投资在我们那个企业当中。其实不只是我们看很多现在新的社会企业也有这样的这个问题，我们去哪里找基金。第二就是我们企业发展起来了，比方说三年五年，然后我们也是可以几乎盈亏了，如果我们下一步我们要再发展出去，我们要把这个企业扩大，主要原因就是企业扩大我们帮助的人会更多。不过第二步的基金从哪里来的？现在在大中华地区这个投资在社会企业这一块的平台不是很多，所以第一个问题就是基金的问题。第二个问题就是说，我们从开始社会企业三年来的一些经验，就是说是不容易，因为你要知道那个社区要求是什么，他们需求是什么，从一个好像一个非盈利机构，我们是怎么帮他，我们怎么把这块做得最好。然后第二部分就是说，我们也要商业的一些运作的一些技术，对吧？我们怎么把产品推出去？我们怎么把我们那个商业搭动起来？所以两方面，因为我们就是说毕业出来也是比较年轻，然后经验不是很多，也不是说哎我们以前已经开办了很多企业，所以很有经验，所以对我们来讲很多都是写死出来的，很多东西，比方说。我以前也不是在时装界或者是生产商出来的背景，我以前是念经济发展的，我是念那个政治的，所以对我来讲这是一个很新的东西，我们要学习在三年内怎么把那个毛变到那个毛衣，这一块我们也要学习，所以从一个学习的角度来讲是非常非常要很快，然后要学的东西要很多，所以我们没有这个知识，我们从哪里拿来的？就是要靠外面的人支持我们。如果这个不懂，我们要找谁来帮我们？我们要找谁？所以现在这个平台还是没有的。如果要参办一个新的社会企业，很多，比方说年轻的毕业出来的社会企业家啊，我有很好的想法，我有很好的知道那个地区要需求是什么，我很想去帮他。第一部分。你的信是对的，不过第二部分我怎么把这个企业大动起来了，所以希望就是说我们这个平台出来谈话的话，就是说我们怎么可以比方说大动一个平台，可以有基金出来支持这年轻的社会企业家。第二就是怎么可以有机缘去比方说从技术培训方面，从企业家比方说要学习财务方面的，可能他财务方面不太强，怎么可以把这些东西学习起来。当有这样的一个软件以后，它就可以把这个企业打动起来，成功的机会才可以大。这是我总结三年内的一些很小的感受。
谢谢。还有 Kelvin， 开发那个期望就可以讲一讲你的经历。
换到英语嘛，因为我觉得我那个普通话的口音太重了。When we started Qifeng, I think, well, when you think about any social enterprise, any social business, and actually any kind of business, the truth is you have to solve a problem. For most traditional business, you think of your customer problem, right? Maybe somebody needs a jacket to wear or some shoes. But for us social enterprises, we think of a larger social problem. But at the same time, we have to have that same mentality of solving a problem. And so if I think about the way that problems can be solved, there are many different ways to solve problems. Some problems definitely need government, need nonprofits, need grants. So for Qifeng's business, you can think of the poorest students who don't even have ability to borrow, to pay a student loan. But then there could be other kinds of businesses, other kinds of models, like Professor Yunus was talking about social businesses, which would have zero profit. Different from that would be a social enterprise, where there is a chance to create so much value, to solve such a problem that you can actually have a profit. And then, of course, we can decide what to do with the profit, whether to help more people or to return to the investors. And then, I think the last category, which unfortunately has been too separate for so long, is simply businesses that think only of profit. I think all of these models are now coming closer together, where everyone is starting to think of their social responsibility and that all of the problems that we try to solve, all the things that we can try to do, are all together. So you can't have a very successful oil company if you pollute your community. You can't sell a lot of goods like Walmart does unless you care about where the energy comes from. And in the same way, us as entrepreneurs, we think of if we identify a problem as we have, how does someone go to school? How does someone pay for their way to go to school? And if we can think of those other ideas and put them together, how do we build a sustainable business, a business that can solve this large problem in a way that we don't always need to ask for help from others? We can sell something, a service that is so valuable that people will come of their own will and support it, and that the customers will get so much benefit that they're willing to use their effort to use this. Then I think that is how you can build sustainable social enterprises.
Thank you, Kevin. And Patrick,
Ashoka, 要搞一个成功的社会企业，我自己觉得很重要的，第一个是选账长，第二个是选那个人，第三个是选伙伴。不是每一个社会问题的领域都可以让你赚钱的，有些是需要慈善继续不断的捐钱的。所以我们选哪些地方开始是非常的重要，在用英文来表达的话，就是你要选那个价值链里面有 value creation 创造价值，有时候哪一个方面你能创造价值，另外一个是在市场机制失败的地方，就是说 market failure 的地方创造价值。我觉得那个就是说现在没有这种服务的，比方我举一个例子，就是德国很有名的一个社会企业，也是我们阿索克的伙伴，他创造利用盲人去做很高阶层的培训，原来都没有这个东西，他现在在做啊，这个是价值创造。那个市场非劣，那比方我们另外一个 fellow Mr. Green， 他发现了医疗的费用非常昂贵，里面呢其实就是他举个例子，就是说这个助听器现在全球销售只有700万，而需要助听器的人是5个亿的人需要助听器，但是太贵了，买不起，里面有很多很多的问题，那就是市场机制失败了，那我们怎么样去创造？所以选择这两个地方是将会有很好的回报。第二就是选人， 往往我们都是 NPO， 我们说哎，我们申请那个基金会啊，壹基金给我们一个grant， 那我们就请一个项目经理来执行了、啊。其实我觉得社会企业最重要的是一个社会企业家。社会企业家 entrepreneur 是什么？ entrepreneur 就是没有成功就成人的那种，就是你就没做完了你就上吊了啊，这个叫社会企业家，我自己的解释。因为你是 entrepreneur 就是要不断的创新，碰到问题尝试，然后去成功。所以我们 NPO 选人的话也必须要注意这个人对这个项目的投身献身的程度。我碰过很多项目的负责人，他们项目做失败了，他说啊也好，我也帮了好多人，但是这不回答我们社会企业里面范畴的问题。第三个是选伙伴，很多那个公益团体他想做一个事，他都想 reinvent the wheel， 就是重新发明轮子。我觉得更重要的是你眼睛从外边看，要跟主流的商业社会去合作。比方 Berme， 刚才那个已经尤努斯博士提到了，他做酸奶他会去自己去做，去找达人，找主流社会最成功的人跟你合作去做，而不要重新发明轮子啊。所以呢这个很重要，也需要跟政府合作，因为它有一套架构的。所以怎样让这个跟主流的商业社会跟政府能搭建一个 win-win 的 situation， 是我们每一个 NGO 都要考虑透彻才能成功的关键问题。好，谢谢。
好，谢谢。其实很重要的对那个社会企业就是那个资金，没有资金不如是善款啊，foundation 的钱，或者是venture philanthropy 公益创投，或者是正经的其他的平常那个market oriented investors 也是很重要的，对一个社会企业的发展。下一部分呢，我就想邀请Tom Hiday and David 来讲一讲关于那个社会创意的投资。Tom， 可以开始。
谢谢。我想跟各位分享一下我们在台湾工作的经验。在台湾的社会企业，我们合作的对象大概分成三类啊。第一类是他雇佣了一些比较弱势的族群，像我刚才自我介绍中提到的，我们目前跟一位 NGO 的朋友合作，那他专门去雇佣这些残疾人士，给他们训练，让他们有了工作的技巧，然后能够慢慢的赚钱。那他雇佣了这一群其他的公司不会雇佣的弱势族群，这是一类的社会企业。那第二类的企业呢，就是他提供一种产品或服务给这些弱势的朋友。比如说我们在台湾有一个旅行社叫观音旅行社，那他专门提供旅游服务给残疾的朋友。一般的旅行社可能没办法照顾这些残疾的朋友，但这些朋友也喜欢出国旅游啊，那这家旅行社专门就提供这样的服务给这群朋友。那第三类的是他制造出来的产品或服务本身就具有一个公益性。在台湾有一个公司叫做农友公司，农夫的农，朋友的友，他们专门生产种子。那这些种子呢，经过他们科技的改良之后啊，能长出来的蔬菜水果特别大，然后让农人能够卖得更好的价钱。那在台湾我们经历过的这三种的社会企业，我们发现他们成功啊，有几个重要的原因啊。那第一个原因呢，其实他们都善用了科技，用了 technology 啊。像我刚才提到的这个农友公司啊，那他就能用科技的方法，让他的种子种出来的西瓜就是特别大，就是特别甜。于是他把这些种子卖到印度去啊，帮助了印度那边非常多的西瓜农人能够卖得比较好的价钱。所以第一个，科技是让社会企业能够成功的关键原因。那第二个原因呢，就是 innovation， 就是创新啊。而且不只是在观念上的创新，其实也在做法上的创新。刚才我们听到尤努斯博士乡村银行或是平民银行的故事啊，其实那就是一个观念创新。因为过去的大银行都觉得说，这些贫穷的朋友他不会还钱给我，所以我不要借钱给他。可是尤努斯博士觉得说，为什么要有这样的成见？为什么要这样假设呢？他打破了那个假设， 然后他又设计了一个方案，就是集体担保的方式哈，让这个乡村银行 Union Bank 能够成功。那这就是我们强调的创新。那在台湾呢，我刚才提到的这个帮助残障朋友寻找工作机会的这个组织，也用一些创新的方法，他提供的训练还有他所使用的配对的方式是很有创新性的。比如说今天一位眼睛看不见的朋友跟今天一位耳朵听不见的朋友，他会把他们变成一组，好，让他们能在训练的过程中能够截长补短，那这样子的创新方式就可以让他们两个人都能够发挥他的潜力。那第三个，也就是最后一点，我想谈的就是，我发现在台湾这些成功的社会企业的另外一个特质哈，都是它能够用到某种 leverage 啊，就是所谓杠杆的原理。那杠杆在 business 的世界里面，意思就是说，它能用最小的资源，然后达到最多的成果。因为大家可以想象，这些社会企业不像一般的企业，很多的资金支持哈，所以它必须要用最少资源来做生意。比如说台湾有一个专门帮助这些辍学的青少年的学习中心啊，他为了防止这些青少年变成社会的问题青少年，他在这些青少年放学之后呢，把他们聚集到一个地方里，给他们训练，给他们彼此的支持。那这个辍学中心他使用了很多学校的场地，那大家知道学校到了晚上基本上没有人的啊，那所以说他用了学校的场地，等于说用了一个闲置的资产，然后去把这个闲置的资产创造出价值。大家想想看，如果这个中心要去别的地方租场地的话，那要花额外的一笔钱，那它这个营运的成本要增高。可是它却善用了一个闲置的资产，一个 idle assets 啊，那这就是我们看到的一个 leverage， 看到的一个杠杆。所以总结来说，我们在台湾观察到社会企业成功啊，可能要善用到科技，然后或者使用一些创新的心态或是方法，最后如果能够使用杠杆，能够找到 leverage， 用最少的资源做最多的事的话，它成功的几率就比较高。谢谢各位。
Okay, perhaps you can speak from your experience in Japan.
Yes. I have been engaged in this arena for about 10 years. And in these days in Japan, social entrepreneurship is becoming a boom. Every day you can find so many news about social enterprises, social entrepreneurship from media, news, and TV. And also, many young people have so much passion for engaging this issue. But the point is scale.We have so many wonderful small social enterprises, but we need to scale the impact. So for me, the important role of the social venture philanthropy is helping their scale up and sometimes same scale. Also, we need to scale out to the other localities. Finding to methodology to scale out, making one program or principles to.In order to share the best program to the other entrepreneurs in other areas. So that we can make a, for example, network for, make network for solving homelessness issues and something like that. So for us, we are investing not only money, but also helping the capacity building, especially for in terms of finding new ideas to solving problems, finding a wonderful theory of change methodology, and also try to kind of social, we call it social franchise. I mean, try to replicate to the whole Japan or maybe to the other places, Asia, to the world. So we try.To get involved business people and non-profit people and emerge and then try to find new methodology of social businesses and social enterprises.
谢谢你 David, can you perhaps wrap up the topic of venture philanthropy and social investments?
Thank you. So,The main thing is serving others. There are many different ways of financing that, and all of my social enterprises that I've helped start, how we get our financing has been opportunistic. It's wherever we can get the money. Sometimes it's grants, sometimes it's loans, sometimes it's equity. and with equity, there are different kinds of equity. So I would say that the most important thing is the ethical fiber and the dedication and the intelligence of the people doing the social enterprises and the investments. That's what's most important. They're finding ways to solve some of society's problems. One of the things that I've learned in creating the iFund, which brought together a large group of iCare organizations and Deutsche Bank, is that we used money from Deutsche Bank and some investors to come in and invest at a very low return, like 1%, where they take the highest risk position in the fund. It's a $15 million fund. And so if there's a loss in the fund, these high-risk investors take the loss to protect the other investors. So it's a way for financial institutions, or more importantly, philanthropy, to put in their money into funds where then you can leverage commercial investment looking for a reasonable return, both financial return and social return. And I think that in China, when you look at all the different social enterprises coming up, that this creating these kind of funds and having the Chinese government be a participant in creating these funds, I think is the way to go. Chinese government is perhaps the best social entrepreneur in the world. I mean, if you look at the transformation of the last 30 or 40 years, it's incredible how China has brought so many people out of poverty. And I think that there are still some gaps that the citizen sector and social enterprise can work on. And so how do we create the right type of financing to support these dedicated individuals to help them find solutions? Thank you.
其实企业的加盟，你就把他们讲的全部总结一下啊。那个社会企业或者是企业，就刚才那个穆罕默德老师说过了，就是那种的企业，成立的原因是为了解决一个社会的问题。那么第二点呢，就是怎么可以可持续发展，不如是一个非盈利机构或者是一个盈利的机构。还有就是把那个资源，不如是那个专钱或者是其他的不同各方面的投资者，怎么可以得到他们需要的回报，还有他们想达到那个社会影响。第四点呢，就是做一个盈利的社会企业，就不可能必须要很关注你的目标。 你的目标开始的时候是为了解决一个问题，其实是赚钱是没有问题的，但是你必须要赚钱之后，也必须要关注你的以前的目标。还有最后呢，就想说，就是很谢谢那个易资金来很包容我们那个盈利的社会企业，还那个中国的公益行业，还有加入他们那个易的家庭，最后就希望他们也是因为有一个非常好的平台，可以做多一些的公益的创投在中国。谢谢大家。